I can say from personal experience that being able to produce music can transform an individual. I once went to a concert with a good friend of mine in Atlanta. I certainly enjoyed it, and I wouldn't go to a concert with any other person. However, he heard little of the passion that obviously emanated from the players and paid more attention to their choice in chords and phrases. The guy has quite the attentive ear, and I respect that about him, if not anything else. But it was a bit obnoxious listening to him for 20 minutes critique every chord, harmony, release, tempo fluctuation, and vocal resonance from the starting note to the end. My friend made it clear he had experience with learning to recognize these minute aspects of music. Musicians are one of the few groups in the world in which training has affected more than their personality or their performance. It has undeniable effects on their physical anatomy and physiology, usually for the better. Trained musicians have the potential to show great analytical reasoning and creativity, and many studies prove this. Philip F. Hsu, a writer for LiveScience.com, compiled several studies from different research institutions into an online article he aptly named Music Improves Brain Function. His article was comprised of researchers with uncovered evidence that musically trained people exhibit distinct changes in the brain. For example, Thorell Trainer, director of the Institute for Music and the Mind, and other researchers from McMaster University conducted research on preschool children with some formal music training. They gave them auditory tests and found these children responded more accurately than children without musical training. Trainer concluded that music training can modify the brain's auditory cortex. Trainer's findings can be found anywhere. Any trained musician can tell you that with enough experience you will learn to be attentive to the small details of performing. Gottfried Schlott, a cognitive researcher from Harvard University, followed up on Trainer's research and conducted a study on musically trained individuals in their early childhood. He found that these individuals also possessed enhanced analytical reasoning and language skills. These language skills are channeled into interpreting the vast size of musical terminology. Music terminology is mainly expressed in languages of Italian and French, including the title of a piece, which could even be in Latin or German. Musical training allows individuals to become familiar with these languages, which helps in learning them in a traditional class setting. As a musician, I suppose the most influential change in our physiology would be an enhancement in our brain's ability to think divergently. This type of thinking involves creating many solutions, usually creative and unique, for a particular situation. Researchers from Vanderbilt University found that divergent thinking is highly prevalent in musicians because creative thinking is part of their routine. After all, no musician can ace a performance without being able to interpret the music to the liking of the composer and appeal to the emotions of the audience. Few musicians play an instrument with only one hand. Even brass instrumentalists, who need only one hand to move their vowels, use the other hand to either move their tuning slides to keep pitch or to move another valve. The Vanderbilt researchers found that musicians have a significantly large corpus callosum because of this. The corpus callosum is the bridge between the right and left hemispheres of the brain. With a larger bridge, so come greater connections between the neurons on the left hemisphere and those of the right hemispheres, which allows you to play a piano or violin with both hands without really thinking. Don G. Campbell stated this process most eloquently in his book, Introduction to the Musical Mind. He stated, the more connections that can be made in the brain, the more integrated the experience is within memory. If the brain needs to improve on a skill and make it more natural, it merely needs to add more neural connections or brain matter, if you will. One of the most interesting traits that arise from professional training is musical synesthesia. Synesthesia is a clinical condition in which the stimulation of one sensory receptor activates the stimulation of another receptor. In musicians, the prominent form of synesthesia is the ability to perceive certain tones as a particular color, or seeing music. Through this process, you can easily identify pitch or sound frequency by merely hearing it. The same process can be used to perceive chords and certain passages in a piece of music. Synesthesia has been used in many endeavors to appeal to a wide array of music listeners, such as Technicolor from a disco ball, or in fireworks displays. Musical synesthesia tends to stimulate deeper feelings and passion to musicians and spectators alike, because it allows you to react to what you hear. Your interpretation of music will generally be the same as a crowd, but synesthesia adds your own perspective into your experience. The colors you see, the memories that come back to you, and the feelings that are provoked are from your own life experiences and your own personality, making every person's experience with music unique. The stimulation of one sense is an observation, a response to your environment. That is the same for everyone. However, when the brain stimulates two or more senses at a time, everyone has a different perception. The fact that this multi-stimulation reveals so much of what makes us unique just proves how amazing of an organ our brain is. All organs in the human body can change function in response to changes in sizes or structure, but none have the ability to make the body as a whole so profoundly productive as a brain. As a musician, I know how imperative it is that your brain is working in optimal efficiency every day, giving you the coordination to handle the technicality of the rhythms, the creativity to interpret a phrase, and the speed to process information adequately. With so much pressure from the mind to handle the daily struggles of a musician, the mind has to live up to the challenge. For this reason, I am proud to say that one of nature's most awe-inspiring gifts is a musical mind.